Well, we come up here for a short break. It's a beautiful spot, still in the archipelago, surrounded by islands, and actually we're on an island. But I want to ask Jyrki one or two questions. I have this thing in my life where I could be more lonely when I'm in, like, for example, Piccadilly in London or Trafalgar Square. I'm surrounded by thousands of people, but I've never been so lonely as then. Then I can be in the wilderness in Lapland or up here right now on an island with just a few people, and, you know, I don't feel lonely at all when there's nobody and I'm here.
True.
So what about with you? Now, do you miss that, the buzz from the stage?
Hectic. And the... Yeah, the hecticness.
So. Yeah.
No, well, when there's a lot of people paying attention on you, like the moment you are, for instance, the moment you are jumping out from the tour bus and going to the venue and there's fans waiting for you and want to talk with you, take a picture with you or something like that. And when the more there is people around you paying attention at you, I think the more lonely you are at the moment. For some strange reason. And I you know, you don't have to read so many books about like artists. Can be modern day artists from the popular culture, like rock musicians or movie stars, that those people who are most worshipped and who have large following, they're most likely most lonely people.
Yeah, they're ones who
in the way, yeah, in that way.
Yeah.
Or they make loneliness
like
an art.
Elvis, Michael Jackson, I mean, people like that are always like hunted and haunted by fans everywhere.
Yeah, and I think the industry makes those people suffer. You have to find your way out from the industry, which, you know, can drive you into that corner or into that situation that you have sacrificed all your life into entertainment. So then, in those cases, those are the saddest cases, I think.